Okay, I think I'm live. Let's see. I've never tried flautas before, but this looks really cool. It says the live has started, but on my iPad it hasn't started yet. If you guys are here, let me know. And yeah, we'll see. Anyways, whenever this starts, I'm going to be drawing a Mickey Mouse today in this little mini sketchbook, and then I'm going to cut this out and put it in my main sketchbook. And then, if time permits, I'm going to work on other drawings as well. Okay, it is working. Hi, everyone. Hello, hello. Yes, I got an ad as well. Hi. Oh my gosh, I can't believe there's so many people. Okay, so I'm just going to start drawing. Well, I've done the sketch and now I'm going to start doing the outlining, maybe with a black fine liner. Hi everyone. Hello. Oh my gosh, there's so many people. Hi. Hi, Danny. Can you say happy birthday, Grace? Of course. Happy birthday, Grace. Okay, now I'm going to start off by just kind of lightly erasing this. Can you say hi, Maddie? Of course. Hi, Maddie. I love your channel. You inspire me so much. Thank you. That means a lot to me. Okay. Might have erased too much, but that's fine. I can still see it, sort of. We'll see. My name is Rosie, and you inspired me so much. Aw, that's so sweet. Thank you, Rosie. You're the best YouTuber ever. You guys are so sweet, actually. Okay, I'm gonna try and do the outlining while also reading the chat. Let's see how that goes. How many sketchbooks have you completed? At this point, I don't know. I used to number my sketchbooks, but I believe I've done at least 40 if we count my 5-year-old sketchbooks. So many people have their birthday today, so I'm just gonna go ahead and say happy birthday to everyone whose birthday it is today. Oh my gosh, I can't even read the chat. You're the best, thank you. Will you remake or add another part to your art tutorial? If you guys like it, I could. I think this drawing is gonna take me a long time to finish because the chat is exploding and I love it. Your drawings are so cute. Oh, that went away. Your drawings are so cute. I love them. Thank you. Hi, I love the way you draw. Thank you so much. I might have made that a bit too thick, but it should be fine. It's fine. Me and my sister are big fans. Thank you. I love your channel. Thank you. You have inspired me to draw. There is nothing that makes me more happier than when someone tells me that I inspired them to start drawing. Like, that means so much to me. Draw Bluey. Yes, I did draw Bluey recently, actually, but not in a video or in my sketchbook. I drew it on a card for a 6-year-old girl. The chat is going crazy. Oh, look at this. I went to Disney last month and I love Mickey. That is so cool. Haven't been to Disneyland yet, but I would love to go someday. This is getting in the way. I think I might have messed that up, but the thing is, even if I do mess up, if I just make some lines thick, no one's ever gonna know. Except for you guys right now, like the 200 people who are here. Oh, 300 right now. Okay. Can you say hi, Avea? Hi. What's this? I'm drawing right now. I'm such a big fan. You inspire me to get better by watching your tutorials. Thank you. I'm wishing you lots of luck on your art journey, and I hope you have an amazing time drawing with me right now. I love your art style. You're truly the best. You're truly the best. Thank you. It feels weird not having music playing, but it's okay. I'm just gonna pretend the chat is my music because it's so sweet and beautiful right now. You're so good at drawing. Thank you. How old are you? I am a minute older than I was a minute ago. I love saying that. I don't even know why. It's looking questionable right now, but try not to question it. Can you say hi, Zara? Hi, Zara. I love your drawings. Thank you. I love how you designed your sketchbook. Thank you. I was actually really worried about this design initially because I felt like it is really different to my normal color palette, and I kind of regretted adding the yellow, but over time, I've come to love it a little bit. Sparkle, you helped me learn how to draw humans. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for making my day with your sweet comment. What type of games do you play? Well, recently my sister and I have been getting into playing with our Nintendo Switch, and we've been playing Mario Bros. Wonder, and that's been fun. I think my favorite character at this point would be Daisy. She loves peaches. I love your art so much. How long did it take you to find your art style? Firstly, thank you. Secondly, I was never actually satisfied with my art style, so I can't give you an exact time. But I guess the truth is we all technically have an art style, but we're just trying to improve it. It's a hard question. I might get too philosophical about this. Okay. Well, I can't believe this took me 7 minutes. I was kind of hoping this live stream might go for half an hour, but I think it might go longer. We'll see. It's always so hard drawing like a perfect oval or circle. Like when I'm sketching, I'm fine. But when I'm outlining it, that's when the pressure is on. Hi, Sparkle. Hi. I love your accent. It's so cute. Thank you. You inspire me so much for my art, and I draw all the time while I'm watching your videos. Thank you so much. These steady hands. Yes. Okay, that one doesn't look too bad. I'm pretty happy with that. Can you show us how to draw clothes, please? I have gotten a request. Well, I have gotten a lot of requests to make a tutorial on how I draw clothes, like a lot. And I think I will. I just need to figure out how I'm gonna do it because I'm not sure how to explain my process, and sometimes my process doesn't even make sense to me. But once I figure out all the details, I would be happy to make a tutorial on that. Can you say hi, Hazel? Hi, Hazel. Sparkle, you have always inspired me. I would have never learned how to draw hair if it wasn't for you. Thank you so much. That's really, really kind of you to say. Have you ever gone to art school? I haven't gone to art school, but I did like do art classes in my school. I did go to art classes, which was really fun. We did fun stuff, like we learned how to draw horses and make stuff with clay and fun stuff like that. What is the time there in Australia? The time is, well, I could say, but the problem is like times are associated with locations and yeah. But it's not night, I can tell you that. That's why it's so bright right now. It's all natural lighting. Oh, dang, I messed this up. Oh well, just make it thick and pretend like I intentionally messed it up. Oh my gosh, there's so many comments. Your drawings are so pretty. You seem like a very nice person. Please keep up the good work. Thank you so much. You are an amazing person. The good thing is that a lot of this drawing, I'm gonna color in with black anyways. So even if the line art is like a bit messy or unsteady, you probably won't notice it, I'm hoping. I love your artwork. What's your favorite color? Thank you. And it changes every time, but all these days, this was my favorite color. Okay, that does not look bright on camera. I think, yeah, this was my favorite color all these days. But recently, I'm starting to like this color. I think it just looks so pretty and like elegant and magical. I think it looks really cool. I love how cheery you are in all your videos. The positive vibes are contagious. Thank you. Your positive comment is contagious as well. Do you have any school tips? School tips, as in like art class tips, or just generally school? Not sure what you mean, but school tips would be being punctual and trying to have fun in what you do, because when you're having fun, the time will just fly past. Hi, Sparkle, your art is so beautiful. Thank you so much. so hard to like draw and talk at the same time, but I'm trying my best. Thank you for working with me here. Okay, wow, there's 300 people. It's going so fast, I can't even read the chat. How do you find your inspiration, Sparkle? It's honestly an interesting process. For example, I did not intend on drawing Mickey Mouse in today's live stream. The only reason why I'm drawing Mickey Mouse is because there is a sketchbook spread here. If I can find it, just give me a second. This one. And the theme is kind of like red, black, and gray and white. So I thought Mickey Mouse would be perfect to match this theme. So I'm going to finish this drawing, color it in, and then I'm going to cut it out and paste it here. And yeah, my inspiration is usually just very... It just varies a lot. Like, it's never consistent. Oh, that comment went away. When did you start art? Also, Mickey's so cute. Thank you. And I guess I just started it, like, when I was 4 or 3 years old. Like, since when I could hold a pen or pencil and use it on paper. I think that was when. Okay. Time for the buttons. And the pants. I was going to sketch in the live stream, but then I thought it might be easier for me to read the chat if I'm just doing the line art, which was partially correct, but also I need to focus on the line art as well so I don't mess up. When did you start YouTube? And please say my name. It's Lillian. Hi, Lillian. I started YouTube in, I think, 2021. I feel like I should remember this, but yeah, 2021. You have a new subscriber. Thank you so much. Who's your biggest inspiration? Who is my biggest inspiration? There's a lot of YouTubers, but I'd say my parents, because they're like really good at art and like their styles are really cool as well. Now this part I can't mess up because this is not going to be colored in with black, so I have to be careful. Please say Zoe. Hi Zoe, you are so inspiring. Thank you. Hi Sparkle, it's my first live. Thank you so much for making it. If you don't know, your art is beautiful. Thank you so much. The good thing is, even though the line art is taking time, the actual coloring for this drawing, I'm hoping won't take time, but I guess we're gonna find out. Or if you are re-watching this live stream, then I guess you can just find out by fast-forwarding. What's your favorite thing to draw? My favorite thing to draw is my dog, because it's just so easy for me, and it's just fun drawing people that you know in real life as a drawing. It's just really nice. Do you know Hasbin Hotel? No, I don't. What is that? Is tomorrow the face reveal? No, not tomorrow, but maybe someday. I mean, I'm not saying no to a face reveal, I'm just saying maybe not now. Can you say hi, Layla? Hi! I wish I was as talented like you. You're so sweet and I love your drawings. Firstly, thank you so much. Secondly, I bet you're super duper talented. Everyone's talented. Believe in yourself, because I believe in you. Did I mess this up? No. Okay, good. I thought I did for a second. Face reveal, 300k. Maybe, maybe not. Maybe, maybe not. We'll see. Okay. These are the most unique hands I've ever drawn, but I love them. I think they look so cute. Hi, Sparkle. Do you have any tips for beginner artists? Also, can you say hi, Indigo? Hi, Indigo. And I have a video with some tips on how to improve your art if you'd like to check that out. But when it comes to beginner artists, I think just finding a specific thing you want to improve on and then just focusing on that really helps. And also just drawing what you enjoy and balancing that with drawing things that you want to improve on is just a good way to make sure you don't lose motivation to keep on drawing. Well, at least for me. Say hi, Brenda. Hi, Brenda. Hi Sparkle, you have helped me so much with sitting down and starting to draw again. I haven't drawn in years because of this drawing blockage. Thank you for inspiring me. I'm so happy I could inspire you, and I know how that feels. There was a point where I did take a couple of months off from drawing because it just didn't feel fun anymore. It felt more like a chore or something, like homework or something, and I know how that feels, but I'm really, really proud of you for overcoming that feeling and for drawing and making it here. I just find that taking the time to sit down and draw, even if it's not every day, but just like once in a while, it's just really relaxing, and it's just a good way to, I guess, spend time with yourself and enjoy the simple things in life, like creating something with your hands. Can you draw Bluey in this live stream? We'll see, depending on time, but thanks for the suggestion. Your art is so, that one went away as well. Your art is so beautiful and special. How do you find your inspiration? Firstly, thank you so much. You're so sweet. And my inspiration, like I said, it really varies, but I sometimes find that color palettes are a good way to give me ideas for what to draw. Like for example, let me just do it right now. Let's say I pick three random colors, like I'm picking them on the left side, which you can't see, but I'm just gonna show you now. Okay, for example, let's say I pick these three colors. This is one way I get inspired because this makes me think of either a mermaid or a character in a forest or a fairy or something like that. And I guess that's one way I get my ideas for what to draw. And time to pack them up. Where do you buy your fine liners? I need one. Well, I buy them in different places. For example, these ones are pretty good. I got them in an art store. And then these ones are also pretty good. And I got these ones online. Does your art style change or stay the same? I feel like it does change over time. Sometimes I used to like make it change. Nowadays, I kind of just let it change on its own. But I guess it's just all part of growing and evolving in your art journey. This tail looks questionable, but I'm hoping that everything will come together when I start coloring. Like, I'm really, really hoping that's the case, because if it's not, I don't know what I'm gonna do. You inspired me to start my YouTube channel. I love your art. Thank you so, so much. I love reading everybody's comments. It's like my favorite part of the process of drawing and editing and posting a video. Like, reading the comments is the rewarding part. I love your videos and drawings, and I have been here since the beginning. Thank you so, so much. I'm just gonna start coloring the small things with this, and then for the bigger things, I'm probably gonna use like a black marker or like something else to color it in. Sometimes when I'm coloring with markers, they do tend to bleed through to the other side of the page that I'm coloring on. So at those times, I like to kind of cover up that page with a piece of paper or some acrylic paint or something. And then I make a drawing like this and I stick it in, or I just paint directly on top of it. Or sometimes I just leave it, but those are just some of the things that I do. Your art is so amazing. Thank you. Okay, this live stream has been going for 20 minutes. I think I'm going to aim for it to go for about half an hour, and by that time we can finish this drawing, put it in my sketchbook, and be done. Or if we want to draw something else as well, we could do that, but let's see. I haven't done a live stream in quite a while. This is actually pretty fun. How do you only have 230k subscribers? You deserve at least 1 million. Thank you. That's so sweet of you to say. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, the good thing is that we are officially done with the line art. Actually, I take that back. I'm going to add a bit of depth here and there. And once I do that, okay, almost done, almost done. Almost there. You are so good at drawing. Thank you so much. Okay, almost, almost. And can't forget these three lines and this button thingy here. Okay, and now I'm officially done with the line art. Have you drawn dragons before? Yes, I have. It was fun. I drew Toothless from How to Train Your Dragon, and that was a very nice memory. Okay, now I'm gonna erase this. And then I like to do this sometimes because I don't want my desk to get too messy. And that is erasing with an eraser like this. And then using my kneaded eraser to pick up the eraser dust. That way my desk doesn't get filled with like eraser dust or the floor as well. Do you have any recommendations for sketchbook brands? I change sketchbook brands quite frequently just because I want to try everything. But the sketchbook I'm currently using is from the brand BURN. It's this one. It's pretty good if you want to try that out. But I'm not sure if it's available like internationally. Not sure. How long does one drawing take you? That depends, but I'm hoping this drawing doesn't take me too long. Now I'm gonna put this underneath and grab a black marker. I might just use this one because it might be quicker, the brush marker. Can you please draw Tom and Jerry? That was actually what I was thinking of doing today. I was gonna draw Tom and Jerry, but then I changed my mind. But maybe I could. Yeah, this is good. Now I can just kind of work on leveling out the shape of the ear as well. Like that. Yep, not bad. You did Mickey Mouse right. Thank you. Your voice is beautiful. Can you say hi, Lizzie? Thank you, and hi, Lizzie. Coloring with marker is so satisfying, and painting with watercolor is also so satisfying, and drawing with pencil, coloring with pencil. Honestly, art is just satisfying. It's like so much fun. I was about to quit drawing, but you inspired me not to. I'm so happy to hear that because drawing is fun and I hope you have lots of fun drawing now. There we go. This is pretty dark. I like it. I think, is it going through? Yeah, a little bit, because I'm like layering a lot, but it's pretty good. Also, this paper isn't really thick as well, so it makes sense if it kind of goes through a bit. I have to be careful around this area. Hello, my cousin is a big fan and wants to start an art YouTube channel. Do you have any tips for her? I made a video about like my YouTube journey, if you'd like to check that out and if that helps. And secondly, congrats and good luck to your cousin. And also, I think some of the best tips that I have came to learn over time for me is probably posting what you're proud of and also just making sure that you're enjoying the process of making videos, because if you're not enjoying the process, then it's really easy to get like frustrated. And yeah, that's what I'd say pretty much. Also, focus on the titles and the thumbnails and just do what makes you happy. This is so much fun coloring with just black. Uh-oh. I'm trying to be perfect. It's not happening, but that's okay. We'll make do with what we got. You should make your own community chat like a Discord. Yeah, I've been suggested that a couple of times. I love your drawings and you really improved me as an artist. Thank you so much. The good thing is that with this drawing, there's not a lot to color. I just have to color his face, gloves, and then all this, and then we'll be done. Hey Sparkle, can you please make a video on all your art supplies or how to use alcohol markers and blending them? Oh yes, I have made a couple of videos about, I think about two videos, about how I use alcohol-based markers and how I work with them and some tips and tricks I've learned along the way, if you'd like to check that out. But I could make an updated one this year as well. Okay, I need a bit of water. I've been talking for like 20 minutes straight. Hey Sparkle, do you have any tips for designing clothes? That is something I struggle at in art, so some tips would help. And also, you have inspired me to draw people. Firstly, I'm so happy I could inspire you. Secondly, when it comes to designing clothes, I kind of just make it up on the go. Like, I kind of think of a theme or a color palette and I kind of work with that. Like, if you watched my recent video where I designed some characters based on random things, like, for example, the character I designed based on a fish was inspired by the color palette and the pattern of the fish and things like that. It's just something I kind of work on as I go. Like, I kind of just make it up as I go. It's a bit hard to explain, I'm sorry. Okay, now it's time for the fun part, the coloring and also picking out the right colors because I don't want to mess this up. I'm going to go with a nice vibrant yellow. Maybe I'll just test it here. Yeah, that's good. That's going to be the button. And now for the shoes. I love your art, Mickey is turning out so good. Thank you so much. I was kind of confused on which Mickey I should draw. Then I decided to go with like the more recent one just because I think it looks really cute. What's your favorite fruit? My favorite fruit is, well, I love all the fruits, but I'd say at this very moment, probably kiwi, because I just like the taste of kiwi, and it's so much fun to just like eat it. It's kind of like you're scooping it out of a bowl, but the fruit is the bowl. It's fun. What pencil do you use? When I'm sketching, I usually use a mechanical pencil, for example, like this one or like this one. And you can also use a normal pencil. That works the same, honestly. Kiwis are my fave to sparkle. What's your favorite marker brand? That is a hard question. I am currently using multiple marker brands. For example, I'm using Artex and Ahuhu and Prismacolor and some other brands from like local stores. And I think they all work pretty much the same in the end. I like all the markers that I'm currently using. And I've also tried using Copic or Copic markers as well. They're really good too. I don't have a favorite though. I think they're all great. Now it's time for these shorts. You need to find a good red color, which is going to be hard, I know. Maybe something like this. That's a good color. Can you draw a mini if you haven't already? I could. Maybe on a different page. I love your artwork. Can you say hi, Ellie? Hi, Ellie, and thank you so much. This is a bit more of like a cherry red, I think. In real life, it looks like a cherry red, but I like it. It's pretty vibrant. I'm liking it so far. And of course, we can't forget this. June should join in more videos. I think he's so cute. I love him. Thank you so much. That's very sweet of you to say. And he's actually currently sleeping like right next to me, but like on the floor. And I would love to have him in more videos as well. I'm literally so obsessed with your channel. Thank you. Okay, next up is the face. So it's kind of going to be like a warm gray kind of color. So let's test out our options. Maybe not that color. Sparkle, how do you draw bang? I'm struggling a little. Like bangs? Oh, that took me a while to understand as well. But like how I currently do it is, I'll just do it here because I have space anyways. I kind of just like draw the face like this, right? And then I kind of just, instead of doing it like straight, what I do is I kind of give it a bit of a bend in different directions, kind of like that. And then, yeah, that's pretty much how I draw it. Okay, I'm kind of struggling to find the right color for the skin, but for now, I'm just going to keep searching. This is a nice color, but I want it to be a bit more warm. When I see a video, I always want to do art. That's really good. Oh, I think this one might be good. I think. Maybe I'll just wait for it to dry so I can... Oh, you guys, can you even see it? No, you can't see it. I'm just going to wait for this to dry so I can see how it looks after it dries. And then I'll pick the final color. Actually, I like it. It's good. We'll go with this. When did you start YouTube? I started it in 2021. You inspired me to start my YouTube channel and now I have 500 subscribers. Firstly, thank you so much. Secondly, congrats. And thirdly, good luck to your channel. I hope you get even more subscribers who love your beautiful art. Okay. This seems to be all right. I'm just going to keep going and hope that it turns out all right in the end as well. Does Mickey have three fingers? He does. Interesting. Love your art videos. You are very inspiring. Do you like to draw book characters or video game characters? Thank you so much. And usually I just draw like random things, but when it's fan art, it's probably something from a show I've watched or a cartoon I like or something like that usually. Okay, we're almost done with this drawing. And ta-da, we are done. I know it looks a bit weird that he's gray, but the reason I did that is because I want to cut a white outline around the character and I want it to kind of look a bit like a sticker. That's why. It'll make sense eventually. You inspire me to start my YouTube channel. I love your art. Thank you. And now I'm going to take this out. And we can add white gel pen highlights if we want. I don't think we need to. But something else I do want to do is I do want to just grab this and just make the line art a bit like thick in some places just to give it a cool effect. And then once I'm happy, I'm going to cut out the drawing and stick it in my sketchbook. It's kind of like this. It takes a long time to do art, but in the end, it turns out nice. I agree. Sometimes drawings can take a long time, or paintings, or just art in general, but it's just really satisfying, you know, to enjoy the process, and you also get like a really cool drawing to look at the end as well. Okay, I'm pretty happy with it so far. I don't want to do too much and like end up regretting my decision to make the line art a bit thicker, but so far, so good. This is the first time I'm watching your live. Thank you so much for making it. It looks amazing. Thank you. Do you know how to draw animals? I mean, I try my best. Hey Sparkle, what sketchbook do you use? Currently, I'm using the sketchbook. It is a Born sketchbook. That is B-O-R-N. Hey Sparkle, Mickey is looking cute. Thank you for saying happy birthday, Grace. Thank you, and you're welcome. Okay, I think I should stop, but I just want to keep on going. It's kind of hard sometimes when you're drawing to know when to stop. Because there's honestly so much you can just do and keep on doing, hoping that it'll make the drawing look even better. Okay. Okay, I should really stop. Maybe just after the shoes. How did you come up with your channel name? That was an interesting process. We were just brainstorming ideas for channel names, and then I love sparkles, so we settled with sparkles, and then Drawz because drawing, and then the Z or the Z because it just sounds cool. Hi Sparkle, where do you get your white gel pens? I usually get them from like a local art store, or I haven't tried it, but I know they're like available online, like on Amazon or something. And recently Artex also sent me a gift. They sent me their gel pens and these work really good as well. Sparkle, can you tell me your favorite thing to draw when it comes to stress? When it comes to stress, I find that I like to paint because I find painting to be really relaxing, and there's also like less pressure for me because if I don't like something, I can just paint over it. And I also like to just generally doodle a bunch of random things, and yeah, and that's what I do. And now I'm gonna stop after this. And now I'm gonna stop. Okay, actually, I take that back one more time. I just wanna keep adding more and more details. What can I say? The thick line art, yes, it's looking thick, but I like it. It's something different than what I normally do. That's why I like it mainly. And the good thing is, even if I do mess up, I can go back and fix it. For example, this chin has gone a bit too high, but I can just use a gel pen to kind of bring it a little lower, like that. Gel pens are very satisfying to use. At least that's how I find them to be. Okay, I might also make this a tiny bit more thin as well. Hi, Sparkle. Just want to stop by and say hi. Hi! Amazing! Thank you! Mickey Mouse looks perfect. Thank you! You're amazing. Thank you! You guys are so amazing, actually. Okay, this is how it's looking. And now we're gonna cut it out. Sparkle, it looks amazing. Thank you! Sparkle, thank you for helping me get better art. Your videos have helped me so much. I finally found my art channel. Oh, went away. Thanks to you. Thank you so much. That means a lot to me. Okay. Now let's cut it out. This part requires just a little bit more focus than some of the previous parts of this process. Just a little bit more. Okay, now to have a look at the chat for a second. Can you please say hi? Hi! Also, does pineapple belong on pizza? Your work is so inspiring. Thank you, and honestly, opinions differ, I agree. But for me, I like pineapples on pizza, especially Hawaiian pizza. I think it tastes really nice. But that's just my opinion, okay? If you don't like pineapples on pizza, that's fine as well. Okay, and now for the hands. I love Mickey's hands, they're so cute. If it's really quiet, I'm sorry, I'm just trying to focus. Now to read the chat again. Will you be posting more digital art soon? I could. I haven't made a lot of digital drawings recently. I've just been drawing in my sketchbook, like, recently. But I do like digital art a lot. It's really fun. It's like a whole different process. Okay. That. Can you please make Mr. June as a human? Yes, I have done that before, like, before I started my channel. I drew myself. And I drew him standing next to me, holding a drink, but like it has a bone on it to like represent his treats and everything. It was such a fun drawing to make. I loved it. And then I made his outfit in the same color as his collar and his leash. And then, yeah, it was really fun. I loved it. How long have you been into art? Like I said before, I've been doing art since I can remember. Like, as in, I've started drawing since I was like 3 or 4 years old, like since I could hold a pencil and use it on paper. But like, I think I really got into art like around 2020 or like a little bit before that. I also did get into art even before that, like in the 2000 and something teens, but then I kind of took a break. Honestly, it's been a bit of a journey, but right now, I love making art, and I do it quite frequently, because it's fun. Whew, this is getting tiring. I'm just gonna cut this out like this, and then work on it again. Okay. I guess that makes it a tiny bit easier. Please say hi, new subscriber. Hi, thank you for subscribing. I love you. Thank you. You are inspiring me a lot. Thank you so much. Sparkle's cutting is so perfect. Thank you. Let's keep going. I'm gonna come back and do this part afterwards. There's probably an easier way to cut this, but I just can't think of it right now. This live stream has been going on for 40 minutes, which is 10 minutes more than I expected it to. But I guess that's fine. We're all having fun anyways. I'm probably your biggest fan ever. I watch you almost every day. Thank you. That's so sweet. I love your drawing. Thank you. Okay, now this part, I need to be really careful because it's like a really weird kind of place and I don't know what shape to cut it out. I'll just do this for now and I'll probably come back and refine the shape a bit. Okay, maybe I can take it inwards a little bit more and see how that looks. A little bit. Okay, not bad. You should make stickers. I think you would be really good at making them. Thank you. I could. That would be a really fun idea. I don't know what I think about this, but I'm just gonna leave it. Anyways, here's how this is looking. And now I'm going to put this all in the bin, the mini bin right next to me. Wait, how about a human Mickey? That is such a cool idea. I could try that sometime as well. Also, I haven't finished recording the video that I was meant to post 2 days ago. The one where I let you guys decide what I draw to celebrate reaching 200,000 subscribers. I still have 2 more pages to fill, so I'm going to be recording that either today or tomorrow. So if you have any more suggestions, feel free to pop them in the community post that I posted. And maybe, just maybe, I could end up drawing yours. Okay, now time to find the page again. Where did it go? Where did it go, actually? 1 second. All right, here it is. I love your art. Thank you. Can you do a face reveal? Maybe sometime in the future. And now we can stick this in. Okay, I love it. It matches the theme so well. What will you draw next? We'll see. I'm probably not going to draw in this live stream currently, but we'll see. So I need my glue stick and let's glue this in. I'm drawing mermaids. That's so cool. Oh, look how it looks from the back. That looks pretty cool as well. Just gonna put glue everywhere, make sure it all sticks. Especially the edges, because sometimes the edges kind of start to come off a little bit, like they start to peel off sometimes. Okay. And now sticking it right in the middle, right there. Okay, and here's how it's looking. I like it. I think I can add some more things around it. Maybe like a quote from Mickey Mouse or something like that. I don't know. We'll see. But maybe I'll just start with sparkles for now. OMG, so pretty and perfect. Thank you. You're so good. Thank you. I'm so confused. Maybe I can like draw something on the border and then little sparkles. I don't know. Looks great. Thank you. Making decisions is so hard. Why is it so hard? Yeah, I could just do like a border. So I'm just going to do a squiggly border for now and just start off with that. Okay, well that's something. I love you, Sparkle. Thank you. And I'm just going to continue doing that. I feel like I should use a darker marker. Maybe I'll use like a black brush marker, maybe. Love it. Thank you, right, Mickey? Yes, I might do that as well. Okay, yeah, this is nice. This is just a little bit darker. And I think it matches well. I might just add like something in the tip of that as well afterwards, but we'll see. What are your recommendations for markers for starters? I would just say for starters, it's actually really hard because like for me, I used a mix of watercolors and markers when I was starting off before I like bought more markers. I would just say buying the colors you need and maybe just buying like a starting set, like one of those sets that have like the colors that a beginner needs. I'm sorry, I'm not the best person to give advice on this. Okay, now it's looking like something. I feel like these two turned out, well, yeah, this and this turned out good. These are questionable, but just don't look too much into it. Okay, now maybe I'll just add like, maybe I'll use a different nib actually. Beautiful, thank you. Do you like K-pop? I've heard some of the songs, like some K-pop songs, like Dynamite. That's pretty cool. Are you a Swiftie? I love Taylor Swift songs. They're amazing. Okay. I like it. It's simple, but it fills up the space. Maybe I can even add like a little heart here, like a two dots or something. Maybe one more heart here. All right, not bad, I like it. I'm gonna repeat the exact same thing on each of these, hoping that it also turns out good. Like that. What's your opinion on otters? I think they're cute. I love how creative you are, thank you. Wow, this live stream is going for almost an hour. It's like double of what I was going for. Anyways, we're almost done, so it's fine. This page is actually to cover up the drawing that I made. So you might remember this from my last short. And yeah, because I used markers, the ink went through to the other side. So I kind of went ahead and used a paint marker to cover it up. And now we're doing this. You always inspire me. I love your art. Thank you. The longer, the better. Thank you. I love drawing with you, Sparkle. That's so sweet of you to say. Thank you very much. Okay, now another heart. Heart, little flower. There we go. The border is officially complete. I don't know if you guys can actually see it though. I hope you can. Draw a fox themed character. That's a really cool idea. Thanks for the suggestion. And now I'm going to grab the white gel pen. And I'm gonna use it to add like some little sparkles and things around the character. Probably gonna write Mickey Mouse down here as well, which means I have to bring this marker back. You're absolutely amazing. Thank you. You're awesome. Thank you. Now let's write Mickey Mouse. There we go. It has been written. And now I am going to, like I've been saying for the past couple of minutes, going to add sparkles all around, but like different kind of sparkles this time. I'm gonna like do these little four line sparkles. I think they look pretty cool. Like that. It's really cool how sparkles just like add that extra sense of detail to a drawing or the background. They're just so cool. Please share how you do full body drawings. I have made some tutorials and some videos on my process of like how I draw anatomy and bodies, if you'd like to check that out. You are amazing. Thank you. You are amazing. Your handwriting is fabulous. Thank you. You're so sweet. I'm pretty happy that these two pages are kind of matching. It wasn't like something I planned on doing when I made this sketch initially, but I'm really happy that they're looking good together. The hard thing with drawing sparkles is knowing when to stop. Not something I am amazing at, because I usually just kind of overdo it, but too many sparkles, it's probably not a bad thing. Can you draw a wolf girl? That's a really cool suggestion. This is such a cute drawing, thank you. Have you done a tutorial on drawing hands? Your art is so good. Firstly, thank you so much. Secondly, not yet, but I have been getting a lot of requests. Maybe I could do one in the future, just like after I feel a bit more confident with drawing hands myself. Because right now, I'm still learning when it comes to it as well. I'm trying not to touch these when I'm drawing the rest of the sparkles in case it accidentally smudges. There we go. I love this drawing. Thank you. Almost there, almost, and okay, one more at the top and a couple more at the bottom. Like that. And there we go. I think I'm about done. Stopping is the problem, like I said. And now the very, 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 very last thing that I want to do is just go ahead and write the date that I colored in this drawing and glued in so I remember when I did it, which is the 20th. And there we go. All done! And now I can officially say that I have finished this sketchbook spread. Let me just kind of zoom out a little bit so you guys can see what we have. I hope that's good. And yeah, here's how it turned out. Let me know your thoughts in the chat. And thank you so much for watching. I'm pretty happy with it. I like how it turned out. And now I'm going to end the chat and the live stream in a minute or two. Until then, I'm just going to read the chat. So cute. Thank you. So amazing. Thank you. I'm your 400th like. Thank you so much. Congrats on finishing it. Thank you. I know, like, usually I don't finish my drawings in the live stream, but I finished it this time, which I'm very proud of. And yeah, I'm just going to keep packing up as I read the chat as well. I love your art. Thank you. Great. Adorable. Thanks. And of course, the scissors and the glue stick. Okay. Yeah, all done. And now I'm currently... I don't want to show you guys the drawing from the recent video I'm recording because it's going to come out next week. But if I skip all that... As you can see, I'm currently this far through my sketchbook and I have this many pages to go. So yeah, that's just a fun update. And here's how this looks. Anyways, guys, that is it for today. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for joining the live stream and for all your sweet comments in the chat. It means a lot to me. And yeah, that's it for today. And I will see you guys in the next video, which I'm hoping you'll love because it's a special for reaching 200,000 subscribers. Anyways, bye!